Do I agree that climate change is the greatest existential threat to everyone everywhere? No, I think the greatest existential threat is humans. The global thermonuclear war, I think, is the greatest existential threat. Climate change is a challenge. It's something that it's bantered about these days because it's the human thing. Only now we start to see the effects of it, but the real consequences are generations away. And the thing about climate change is people who want to ignore it say, oh, you're saying that, you know, it's going to destroy the planet and everything. No, the planet's going to be fine. George Carlin had a really great routine about this decades ago. He said, you know, yeah, the pollution, plastic, global warming, the planet's going to be fine. We're just not going to be around. This is the thing. Human beings are very adaptable, but our civilization that we have established, the way we've built it, is dependent on several things. Ocean levels are very critical because 80% of all humans live within 100 miles of an ocean, number one. So as far as like what we've built, as far as like cities, major, there are no huge like 12 million person cities that are like deeply inland. I mean, all the really big populations are and everything that we built as far as like infrastructure and industry, all the industry is near the ocean because our entire global industrial network is built upon moving things on the ocean, moving raw supplies, ores, fuels, and such, moving finished goods. Everything moves to and from industry by the ocean. So when, as ocean levels rise several feet, several meters, many meters, as cities get flooded and encroached, and as industrial centers get flooded over, the impact economically, industrially, to the culture and the technologies that we built is going to be profound. It's the motorcycle gangs. But people today, my generation, we're not going to have to pay diddly squat. You know, those of you who are in your 20s, if you have kids, it's your kids that are really going to pay the price, and your grandchildren that are really, really going to pay the price. Because those are the people who are going to live in a world where it's going to be so friggin' expensive to exist. Food is going to be very hard to grow. Industry is going to be impacted. Energy generation is going to be impacted. People are going to have to move inland. You know, billions of people are going to have to move inland on land that's already occupied. And the social upheaval of just the migration of populations from the coasts inland cannot be overstressed. We're talking billions of people are going to have to move. Trillions of dollars in industry is going to have to be scrapped and moved. And the potential for human conflict, for nuclear exchanges, for wars to break out over resources, over land, not now, not 5 years from now, not today, but two generations from now, it's going to be a world that you don't want to live in. And it's all going to be because very large areas of the world are going to be too hot for people to live in, and sea levels are going to be too high for most current industrial places, ports, industry. It's all going to have to be moved inland. And we're talking about moving inland to where things are already there. So you're going to be moving ports and moving industry into areas where people now just live. Suburbs are going to be like leveled so that we can build factories. Farms are going to be raised so that we can build apartment buildings. It's talking about the cost of it and the fact that the regular average person, the average, you know, the way we think about the average working person now, if you're working at a Starbucks or a Walmart or something, the cost for the regular person to live in that future world two generations from now is going to be astronomical. The cost of food is going to be absolutely off the charts. Yeah, great consequences. not today, not in 5 years from now. Everybody who's bitching, moaning about it, about being a nothing burger, they're all gonna be dead. They're all gonna be dead and buried, dead and cremated long before the shit hits the fan. But 2 generations from now, this will not be a planet that you as a human will want to be living on with the other 15 billion people who are trying to survive on very little land and very little food, with a very hot planet. The planet will be fine. It's just we're gonna go extinct. And then, you know, tens of millions of years, hundreds of millions of years from now, the planet will reset. New species, new plants, new ocean life. It's the Earth will reset, but we will be gone. And we would have done it to ourselves. And there you go. But, yeah. But in the next 10 years, the greatest existential threat is global thermonuclear war. China, there's a great article in the Times this weekend about the possibilities of escalation with China just over the next few years. The situation in the Ukraine, there's lots of potential for, you got the Indian-Pakistani problem, got the Middle Eastern states with nukes. There are so many ways that the whole thing can just blow up in an hour. That's the greatest existential threat, is nukes. But if we don't blow ourselves up with that, well, in a few generations, the world's gonna be pretty much an unlivable place. Pretty much. Like I said, it's not like everyone's gonna die from the heat wave, it's just the catastrophic economic and industrial and political and sociological upheaval by billions of people moving inland and trillions of dollars in industry having to be moved from where it is now to being moved 50, 60 miles inland where people are now living. You can't even quantify that. So yeah. But that's why the young people have to be concerned. It's your world, it's your future. It's not my future. Don't listen to people my age. Don't listen to the opinions of people who are older than me about what the future is gonna be. It's your future. If you're 25 years old, you're 30 years old, it's your future, not mine. I'm not gonna be there. So yeah, you have to fight for the world that you wanna live in. Don't listen to older people when talking about the future. Because the old people aren't going to be around, and they know it. That's where I work. At the bench.